You ready?
What are we going to sing it?
Yeah, you're going to sing the
harmony? The chorus, yeah, okay. Okay. right. me.
I know I'm right
for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you, you better be home soon.
There's not many that turn up like that, but that one was, I literally got out of bed, went to the piano and took it down to rehearsal, and we used to hang out in the dressing room at Countdown while they let in all the 14-year-old girls. And I taught it to these guys, and we got three-part harmony going in the dressing room. Remember that?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, we had no middle eight, actually. I think Mitchell Froom probably convinced us that we needed a middle eight, because Mitchell's always trying to make things more complicated. Don't say no, don't say nothing's wrong.
When you get back.
But I'm happy it's there now.
Yeah, because the first time I heard the song as being a kind of a country song more than an actual... I thought of it as a sort of an R&B kind of soul song when we first...
It was a bit country the way it ended up, I think. Mm. I got pulled aside by some guy, a punter, at a punk gig in Melbourne, the Prince of Wales, shortly after that came out, that, and he just went, hey, Neil, CFG. And I went, what are you talking about? You used to write good songs. And walked away. And I assume he was talking about Better Be Home Soon.
CFG.
Groundhouse Video, Slate 1, Take 3.
She came all the way from America. She had a blind date with destiny.
True story. Girl had come to New Zealand shortly after Split Enz and was a big Split Enz fan, and eventually met me because I was on tour with Dave Dobbin, strangely enough, in Palmerston North, and I had a temperature of like 101 or something, really hot. Sent me a letter and said, please, I have to meet you. So I crawled out of my sick bed and said a quick hello and maybe signed a record or something, and then I went back to bed. And later on, I was told that she was spotted dancing with Gary McCormick in the hotel bar, and I think he spun her a line that he used to go to school with me. And
although the line... I saw you lying in the arms of a poet.
Poet, yeah. Right. I saw you lying, yeah.
I saw you lying in the arms of a poet. I heard him tell you to tantalize in lies. What do you know?
What do you know?
Years later, of course, she turned up, and you forget, write a song, you forget that there's real people involved, and was not really very happy about what I had written.
Right.
Not that I'd
been secretly greatly flattered.
That's probably going to get me into trouble, that
again.
Description, but anyway, again, anyway. Was kind of accidental on the day, I think, but it became like one of those signature things where the minute you hear it, you know the song's coming. And really, we'd be stupid if we didn't put one of those in the front of every song we ever did, but we don't think...
That's the Kiwi party strum, though, isn't it? Like when someone picks up a guitar at a Kiwi kumbaya, if you will, it's usually they just lay behind the song.
It's the big backbeat, because you're playing the drums as well as the guitar. I think it's okay still to say that's the Māori strum. You know, that's what I used to tell people, and it is what I equate with really good sing songs that we've had many times over the years. I was at Tim's house one day, and there were some people over visiting. I wasn't feeling very sociable, so I went in to play the piano. And I think when I was writing the line, they come to build a wall between us, we know they won't win, I was referring to the fact we had visitors, and I don't know why I was giving them so much. I went home, made a little demo. It didn't have the B3 organ solo, which Mitchell Froom supplied. And we played it the first time at rehearsal, Nick, and it wasn't that good, was it?
I can't remember what groove we... the way we tried to render it. But
I think it was an absence of a groove was probably the main thing. It was probably like...
There is freedom within. There is freedom without. Try to catch the deluge in a paper cup.
The verse had a kind of a stoppy-starty sort of bass line that... was suggesting what Mitchell's sort of...
Show them the bass line on there.
Just
Yeah, it's got more space.
It's just got space, and then the chorus would be...
Can you do your signature?
And then that, yeah.
Intro, the signature, hang on. Quiet, please. Yeah, there it is, see?
And that boo da 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 da. It was Mitchell's left hand. He always to actually embark
don't
give
on him credit for
well,
that.
Well, credit where credit's due. Oh. He actually taught me to think of bass that way. It's a James Jameson style hook that is easy to play on a bass. You know, with when you're trying to avoid the root note, you sort of dance around it with this kind of. And Mitch, he still does it.
Everywhere you go, always take the weather with you. Everywhere you go, you always take the weather. Everywhere you go, you always take the weather with you. Everywhere you go, you always take the weather with you.
Tim and I spent about 2 weeks, probably it was only about 2 weeks, preparing at that time. We're trying to write songs really for the first time in earnest for what we thought would be a Finn Brothers record at some point. And he came in with the line, walking round the room singing stormy weather. He was going like that, with that.
There it is.
I was strum again, you know. and I started going. Exactly like that.
There's a small boat made of China. It's going nowhere on the mantelpiece.
There's a few lyrics that come along and you're proud of. I'm really proud of that line. And also, I quite like Julius Caesar and the Roman Empire.
Mm.
Couldn't conquer the blue sky. It's always nice to mention historical figures in your song. Somehow that always kind of... I know Chris Martin, there was one big song of theirs. He mentioned Roman centurions or something. We're hanging out at Pihar just before that. I suspected he ripped me off, but that's okay. No, he wouldn't mind. He wouldn't mind me saying that. He's a good man.
It's too enormous, but on the island is just right. It's the perfect.
The decision seemed like a really good one to try and bring Crowded House back together after having been in Fleetwood Mac, been part of a great classic ensemble and seen how those songs are still vibrant and how you can introduce new elements into that and it'd be revitalizing. And I think the album is broad, but it's definitely got a more upbeat live band feeling about it. And we were lucky to be able to record it just in the weeks before the pandemic locked everything down, so we have live band tracks in the studio, which would have been impossible. God, we get to play music together in a room, and we get to play it to audiences in about 2 weeks' time. I mean, give thanks for...
Mm.
Hey now, when the world comes in.
Don't worry about the high notes.
All right, yeah. Falsetto is going to be a jump.
No, but we don't need it. It's fine. Doesn't matter. You were trying to get up to that. Huh?
Yeah.
All right, one more on that.
Hey now, hey.